Good morning and a warm welcome. I am Pradosh Sharma and you are watching News Flash. Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal was granted bail by the Supreme Court in a case linked to excise policy which faced corruption allegations. He filed 2 petitions challenging his arrest and seeking bail. The NIA conducted searches in Punjab related to its investigation into the attack on the Indian High Commission in Canada by pro-Khalistan supporters. Junior doctors in West Bengal continued their protest overnight at Arjigar Medical College, demanding justice for the gruesome assault and murder of a trainee doctor. Despite a Supreme Court deadline, the doctors vowed to continue until their demands were met. Samajwadi Party Chief Akhilesh Yadav compared Hindu CAs to mafias, triggering outrage among BJP leaders who accused him of insulting Sanatan Dharam. BJP spokesperson Shehzad Poonawalla criticized the remark, claiming it reflects the Indie bloc strategy to use religion for vote bank politics. India is set to establish 100 radars across the country by March 2026 to enhance weather forecasting capabilities. With 39 radars currently operational, the government plans to add 61 S-band, C-band and X-band radars. Congress leader Jagdish Taitlar pleaded not guilty to charges including murder in the connection with the 1984 riots. He is accused of provoking the killing of 3 men near Pulpangash Gurdwara in Delhi. Police used water cannons to disperse protesters demanding the demolition of a mosque built on encroached government land in Mandi, Himachal Pradesh. The mosque management has been given 30 days to remove the encroachment as it occupies 232 square meters for exceeding the approved 45 square meters. Kanpur reported its first swine flu case this year involving a 70-year-old man recently returned from Gurugram. The patient is isolated at Lala Lajpat Rai Hospital, with doctors closely monitoring his condition due to the contagious nature of this virus. The city administration has issued a swine flu alert to prevent further spread. External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar condemned the gruesome assault and murder of a trainee doctor at Arjigar Medical Hospital in Kolkata, stating that no one in the country is untouched by the outrage. He emphasized that women's safety remains a crucial issue in India, highlighting the growing public protests. It is time for a break now. We'll be back with more news. Stay tuned.
इस तरह आरकेडीएफ विश्वविद्यालय राज्य और देश के आधुनिक और उच्च विश्वविद्यालयों में से एक है। आरकेडीएफ यूनिवर्सिटी, अ वर्ल्ड क्लास यूनिवर्सिटी, एजुकेशन ग्लोरिफाइज नेशन।
US President Joe Biden will host the next Quad Summit at his Delaware residence next week, welcoming leaders from India, Japan and Australia. This marks a rare diplomatic gesture, underscoring the importance of Quad in Biden's foreign policy. India will host the summit in 2025. Gunmen killed 15 Shiite civilians in central Afghanistan in an attack claimed by the Islamic State group. 6 others were wounded in the attack. Hamza bin Laden, son of Osama bin Laden, is reportedly alive and actively leading Al-Qaeda, according to new intelligence. The Taliban is allegedly in regular contact with him, providing protection as Al-Qaeda plans its resurgence. The US imposed sanctions on 4 Chinese entities and 1 Pakistani company for supplying Pakistan ballistic missile program. The Beijing Research Institute of Automation was among the entities sanctioned under US missile sanctions laws. Port Blair, capital of Andaman and Nicobar Islands, has been renamed Sri Vijayapuram by Union Government. Home Minister Amit Shah stated that the name change reflects India's efforts to remove colonial imprints. A Kolkata court rejected the CBI's request to conduct a narco test on Sanjay Roy, the accused in the Arjigar Medical College rape and murder case, after Roy refused to consent. The court ruled that such tests require the accused approval, citing 2010 Karnataka High Court judgment. Following the resignation of former Bangladeshi PM Sheikh Hasina, over 1,000 attacks were reported against minorities between August 5 and August 20. Hindus were primary targets, with attacks occurring in 49 districts, especially in Khulna. The Indian government urged for immediate action to halt the violence. 4 Indian Army personnel were injured during an encounter with terrorists in Jammu and Kashmir's Kishtwar district. The security forces have controlled off the area and operations are ongoing. One of the injured soldiers was evacuated to a commandant hospital, while others are receiving local treatment. West Bengal CM Mamata Banerjee announced that 29 people died due to disrupted medical services during protests over the rape and murder of a trainee doctor. Banerjee offered Rs 2 lakh in compensation to the victim's family and urged end to protest to restore normal healthcare services. That's all for the headlines of the day. For more updates, download the app and keep watching Rhythm.